Okay, so a big question is, what is flood and drain and what is constant flow? And how does that relate to you within your aquaponics system? Okay, so I'm about to show you how it all works, but I want to actually explain first what it means. It's only relevant if you're using a, if you have a media bed, so if you've got gravel or expanded clay within your system. So if you're running a nutrient film technique system, so the PVC piping, also known as NFT, you don't need to worry about this. The same with rafts or your deep water culture. This isn't relevant for you. It's only relevant if you're wanting to have media, okay? What flood and drain is, you have, well, we'll show you in another video. yeah, it's coming next. But that's, you really only need to know if you're using the media, okay? So I'll show you in a tick, and then I'll bring you and show you how well it's working over here. So I'll see you in a sec. Okay, so we've got the constant flow happening and we've got the flood and drain happening. Now, I've been showing you before how the flood and drain causes us to lose the water out of our fish tank. That's why a sump is always a good thing. But it's at that constant level for that, right? So we know the flood and drain part will drop the water down to about here, and it's getting very close to wanting to drain out. Your constant flow, however, you can see there's actually a water line here. So this is the part that's constantly got water in it, and it's constantly flowing out, which is why it's called a constant flow system. Now, I do need to put a bend on there just to make it look a bit neater. But what's really awesome is that you can actually see here. So this is what the wet media section will be under here, and this is the dry part. This part will never flood. It will always stay dry. The water will always flow over here, and you have the media guard to make sure that none of the gravel will go into that standpipe and block it and block anything. How cool is that? This is awesome. It's working. A little bit more water needs to be added, and then we're going to be gassing off the chlorine. Then I'll be adding in the filter media into that filter, which is predominantly going to be for removing the solid waste. But how awesome is this? I can seed it with bacteria from that aquaponic system, and this will have fish in a couple of weeks, hopefully. Awesome. Okay, so I've just shown you how it looks in the empty barrel system, and whether it's a barrel system or a huge big system, it's the same process. You're still using your bell siphon and know if you're wanting a flood and drain. Now, you've seen what it looks like when it's all empty. Now, we're going to have a look at what it looks like with clay. So my left-hand side, this is flood and drain. So that means the water will flood up to this level here, and then it will drain back out again with the help of the bell siphon that's in there. Okay, so I'll be putting a link to the bell siphon up in the top of the video, but you can't see any difference between moving over and having a look. This is a constant flow system. So you saw that in the earlier video. The water is constantly at this level, and we have a couple of centimeters of dry media, the same with that one, but the water is constantly at this level. But you cannot tell the difference between these two systems. On the left is flood and drain, on the right is constant flow. It looks exactly the same. We just simply got the water flooding up and flooding down, or the water staying constantly here. Now, if you're running a flood and drain, people will often say it's better for your roots. Well, these are in a constant flow, and these are growing really, really well with their feet constantly wet. It means that if you're going to have constant flow, you have to have lots of aeration within your system. The flood and drain, and this is the advantage of a flood and drain system, because the water is draining out, the roots are getting lots of air, and then it's flooding up again, and then they're getting the nutrients again. So it's a good advantage for that. But the constant flow works just as well as long as you've got good aeration happening. Aeration can happen because of the water is just simply moving around, and I've got that in plenty of places within the system. This causes aeration, so the water coming in, I've got water coming in to my solid separator here, the water draining out. All of these things cause aeration and water movement. So that is the key differences between flood and drain and constant flow, but look at it, you can't tell the difference. But you do hear the difference when you're hearing it draining out. Okay, so hopefully that's given you a really good understanding of the difference between the two, and then for you to decide which one you want to do. Some people do struggle to get a bell siphon working, and it's the bell siphon is what you need to have happening in your flood and drain. And there is a video up top that will show you where to go for that and have a look, and even how to build one. If you struggle with it, you simply take the bell out and run a constant flow. It's as simple as that. Or you can make it hard. Let's stick with simple. Simple's good. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you've got any questions or comments, make sure you do leave them below and hit that subscribe button so you can find out when I've got more videos being posted. And don't forget to follow me on other social media, because I do different lives on different social media on different days. So, again, thank you for watching. I really value and appreciate your time, and I hope you enjoyed it.